everyone is still reeling from the shocking defection of Stone Cold Steve Austin to the Alliance. But we're riding the momentum of Kurt Angle's winning the WCW title and the imminent return of The Rock. But which side will he choose? Along with Michael Hayes, I'm Kevin Kelly. We welcome you to Metal
Hounds Fury Lynn.
Kevin Kelly, I don't know if there's been a more important Raw ever for the WWF and for the Alliance as well. What side will the most entertaining man, the most electrifying man in sports entertainment choose?
Weighing 253 pounds, Mark Jindrak.
This is our first time seeing Mark Jindrak in action here on Metal. This guy is put together.
Doesn't look like he drinks much beer, does he?
Certainly does not. He'll be taking on Jerry Lynn. Jindrak, very young, just getting his feet wet here in sports entertainment. We'll see if he can combat the skills of the veteran Jerry Lynn as we count down to this Monday's Raw, which Michael put so succinctly, the most important broadcast, I think, in World Wrestling Federation history. Because which side will The Rock choose? We know he's going to be back. He will be in Philadelphia at the First Union Center this Monday. But which side will The Rock choose? Will he take Mr. McMahon up on his offer, or will he listen to the words of Shane McMahon?
Well, both Shane McMahon and Vince McMahon have screwed The Rock on a number of occasions. But if memory serves me correctly, and I know it serves The Rock correctly, it was Vince that did it last in WrestleMania, then in the Raw that followed in Fort Worth.
We'll find out which decision The Rock makes as Jerry Lynn rings up the left arm of the one-time basketball star, Mark Jindrak. And of course we know that Kurt Angle is now the WCW champion with a win on SmackDown over Booker T. But a rematch has been ordered for this Monday's Raw.
Oh, man.
It will be Kurt Angle defending the WCW title for the first time against the former champ Booker T.
What a great match that was on SmackDown.
It was tremendous.
Oh!
Oh, Jerry Lynn. Down off the top. We'll have highlights of that later on, and I think you can really speak volumes of some real heroism, I think, by Kurt Angle. Not to overstate it, Michael, but you know what? Kurt Angle wants the ball. He wants to be the leader of the WWF, and he really showed he deserves to be in that spot.
Kurt Angle is that kind of guy that I want to go hang out at nightclub with, if you know what I mean. But if I got somebody leading my team, yep, sign him up.
Well, Kurt Angle is now the WCW champion, but a rematch ordered for this Monday. We'll have more on that later on as Jerry Lynn makes Jindrak pay for an inexperienced mistake. You see the power of Mark turning him over. Side slam, center of the ring. Teddy Long gets a two, and the hand was coming down for the third time.
There was the inexperience of Jindrak not hooking the leg and getting his upper body on Lynn's upper body. He might have had a three count there.
Invasion is over, but the siege is on. Interpromotional matches here in the Hour of Metal. Just a few moments, we'll see Haku take on Sean Stasiak. As Jindrak delivers vertical suplex, center of the ring. Here's the cover. Two. Not enough, though.
A little late with the hook, but at least he did get the hook.
And I'll tell you what, I got to be impressed, Michael, with the presence, the athleticism of Rob Van Dam. Oh, wait a minute now. Off the clothesline, another near fall.
Rob Van Dam, I'll tell you right now, he's damn impressive. I mean, I'm not trying to repeat what you just said. But, I mean, some of the maneuvers this guy comes up with, I mean, he thinks he's all that. I'm not agreeing with that. I don't know if he's, you know, God's gift to women. I'll tell you what, inside that squared circle, he matched up with the Hardys quite well.
Certainly did. To defeat athletes of caliber of Jeff Hardy and Matt Hardy in consecutive nights, I think speaks volumes about the talent of Rob Van Dam. Jindrak has carried the fight to Jerry Lynn. He's got him in position now, and Jerry Lynn rolls that shoulder up. It's going to be tough to keep the veteran Jerry Lynn down. You're going to have to do more, I think, Michael, than just hit one big move and then go for a cover.
Oh, I agree with that. I mean, Lynn is a veteran. But, you know, you talk about Van Dam. I don't know on any given night, because both of those matches could have gone either way with the Hardys, that if Van Dam takes on the Hardys, the next time you'll see the Hardys defeat Van Dam. But what about that tag match with Van Dam and the new U.S. champion? Who better than Canyon?
Oh! Whiplash-like move there. Jerry Lynn escaped the full brunt of the power bomb.
Hey, that's what I always say. If you're in trouble, go for the eyes.
Well, both men are down. Referee Teddy Long applying the count. Of course, we cannot say enough about the just shameful acts of Stone Cold Steve Austin turning his back on the World Wrestling Federation. And you have to know that Mr. McMahon has to be panicked by the defection of Stone Cold and his WWF champion now working for the Alliance.
Well, you know what? I've tried not to talk about it. I mean, that's how angry I've been. If Stone Cold Steve Austin thinks that he just screwed Kurt Angle, he's wrong. He turned his back on every one of us here in the World Wrestling Federation. And you know why? Because Stone Cold is paranoid.
Jerry Lynn missile drop kick, glancing blow. Don't know if he got all of it. Is it enough, though? And no, it's not. Well, of course, Stone Cold Steve Austin turned his back on all the fans that made the Texas Rattlesnake who he is, all for selfish gains. Bulldog! Great counter by Jerry Lynn. Leg is hooked. Thought that would have been it. This has been a tremendous opening contest. As we mentioned, more interpromotional matches as the battle between the WWF and the Alliance continues. Now Jindrak on his feet first. Look at this maneuver. Modified powerbomb. Tiger driver. Center.